When you look at gravel vs cyclocross bikes, on the face of it they are nearly the same. Delve deeper into exactly what they are designed for, though, and you'll find some small differences that make them optimized for these two quite different disciplines. Whether you're in the market for one of these bikes, looking to try something different, or simply curious, we're here to explain the difference. Gravel tires vs cyclocross tires and clearance. Let's start at the crux of off-road riding, grip. You'll find that both cyclocross bikes and gravel bikes often have wider, knobblier tires for tackling mud and dirt. But there are some subtle differences beyond that. Firstly, cyclocross tires are limited under UCI rules to a maximum width of 33mm, although this isn't enforced at local elite level, as bikes tend to be designed from the top level down. Cyclocross bikes will be optimized for clearance for 33mm tires. You'll find mud clearance in the fork and rear triangle between these tires and the frame, but not a huge amount of space for wider tires. Gravel, on the other hand, is blissfully free of UCI rules and intervention. Therefore, there's no limits on tires, and gravel riders and designers have made full use of this. Cyclocross has traditionally been a winter sport in Europe, although it's very popular in the USA and in Australia year-round. Most cyclocross tires feature really aggressive tread and softer compound rubber for use in muddy, grassy conditions. Summer-specific tires feature a lower profile or often worn-down winter tires. Frame geometry differences. To understand the numbers behind the different geometry in gravel bikes vs cyclocross bikes, it helps to think about their design purpose. Cyclocross bikes are perhaps one of the most niche of all bike designs, built for 45 minutes to 1 hour of intense thrashing around deteriorating muddy fields and obstacles in pretty terrible conditions. Cyclocross racing demands tight, precise handling and efficient power transfer, good mud shedding design, as well as a preference for lightweight features. Gravel bikes tend to have a much wider scope, from hour-long jaunts to day-long rides, or even multi-day bike-packing trips. Racing, touring, or just riding, there's a greater diversity of designs within the gravel bike category, but all need to give stability and control over a much wider mix of terrain. Cyclocross bikes tend to have a shorter wheelbase, higher bottom bracket, and more aggressive riding position with racing in mind. They'll also make the most of the front triangle, often with a horizontal top tube to make shouldering the bike over barriers and other obstacles easier. Gravel bike geometry does vary a lot, although comfort tends to be higher on the priority list across all subgenres from racing to trail-oriented builds. Gravel bike vs cyclocross gearing. Going back once more to intended use, gravel bikes tend to have a greater gear range than cyclocross bikes, although this is not always the case. Imagine a gravel tour, for example. You might need to grind up some technical, steep inclines as well as sail down some smooth tarmac, so having a wide range of gears here is really useful. Cyclocross races tend to include less varied terrain, and when it comes to the really steep stuff, it's often unrideable, or quicker to dismount and run. Rather than employ much larger cassettes, these racers tend to opt for simpler gearing. Commonly, they will come with 1X setups, a pretty regular find in gravel riding, too. Mounts or no mounts? Gone are the days when cyclocross bikes didn't even have bottle cage mounts. Although bottles can get in the way during racing, most cyclocross bikes do now have mounts for bottles, either for training or for really hot races. Although some carbon fiber race-oriented models have omitted them, most gravel bikes have not only bottle cage mounts, but a huge array of other bosses for fitting mud guards and racks. In some cases, you will even find extra storage on the fork legs, top tube, and under the down tube. Don't let that stop you planning an adventure on your cyclocross bike, though, as you can fit most bike-packing bags without any racks or other fixings on the frame. Finishing kit differences. You might find a few subtle differences, like flared bars, opens a new tab for gravel riding that you wouldn't find on cyclocross bikes. These offer a wider, more stable position for descending rough or steep terrain, but at a small aerodynamic disadvantage. It's the reason they haven't really taken off in cyclocross. Of course, again, there's a lack of UCI regulation when it comes to gravel, so you can run whatever bars you like, even excessive flared bars, super wide bars, or even straight bars that wouldn't be allowed in professional cyclocross racing. So can both bikes make good gravel and cyclocross bikes? Absolutely. Do you strictly need two different bikes for drop bar dirt? No, though it could be handy if you're getting really into one or the other. You can certainly make adaptations to your bike to make it suitable for both gravel and cyclocross, although that'll depend on what you're already running. It could be easier to start with a gravel bike, as you can easily fit narrower tires, but you can't get added clearance on a cyclocross bike where there isn't any. If you're looking to buy a single bike to do both, there are a few bikes on the market that have this in mind, like the Rebel CGR. We are almost wrapping up. These are the common differences between these two. Hope you liked this video. Please comment, share, and subscribe to this channel for more videos.